Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching Fruitech. OnePlus already started rolling out big January OxygenOS 16.0.2 version for all eligible OnePlus devices, and it's already available for OnePlus 13, OnePlus 12 and Nord series. Only OnePlus Nord C and OnePlus 11 series devices left to get this update. I was using old OxygenOS 16.0.1 V300 on my OnePlus 11R, but yesterday I got the new OxygenOS 16.0.2 V400 via release candidate section. So I decided to test this release candidate version and to provide the genuine verdict about this update. Today, in this first part of video, I am going to review everything from new changes and the features along with the two different bugs I found in OnePlus 11R. The changes and the features I am going to review are almost same for OnePlus 11 users as well. Our channel not only reviews the features and the changes of OxygenOS updates, but also provide the genuine verdict to upgrade your device or not. If you think our content is useful, then consider to like, hype and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Now without further delay, let's get started. Once you install this update, the OxygenOS version details will be updated to the new OxygenOS 16.0.2 V400. Same will be available in the version section. SOTA version will remain same as EX01 V120 P02. Finally, the security patches are updated to the latest January 2026. Let's check out all the new changes and the features of this version is available in OnePlus 11 or not. The first set of features and the new changes are related to the home screen and the launcher customizations. If you are using the application icon shortcut in OxygenOS 16, now we can hold over the application shortcuts and can move or change their position as you want using the drag and drop feature. Also in this update, we can enlarge the cloned application icons and able to add the shortcuts for cloned applications. As you shown earlier, we can change the shortcuts of icon position by using the drag and drop feature. Next, we can add all the OnePlus and third party applications 2x1 widgets in a stack format. We can expand these widgets and can remove any widget by long left swipe gesture easily. If you haven't got this update yet, you can use these launcher features by installing this launcher on old OxygenOS 16 version. Its video review link is available in the description and in iCard. Next, in a smart sidebar, we get a new storage cleanup shortcut. Once you add it, you can launch storage cleanup from anywhere in the system and can clean the storage to improve the device performance. Next, if you open the phone manager after updating to this version, you will get the pop-up message mentioning allow automatic block list update or Wi-Fi or mobile data. I recommend you to tap allow for this setting because it helps to automatically update the database of the block list, which ultimately helps your device to protect against the malicious activities from suspicious applications. Next are some new features of new OnePlus Photo application. The OnePlus Photo app is updated to the new version 16.15.20. In this version, we can edit any photos or videos present in the private safe album without removing them from the private safe. In previous OxygenOS versions, we needed to remove them from the private safe album to edit them. OnePlus has improved the thumbnail phrasing method in this new update, which helps to speed up the display of the thumbnails of album in application. Next, we got new filters for album setting to display specific content like motion photos, screenshot and screen recordings, and edited options, making it easier to filter the images and videos. These filters are also available for images available in the photo section along with the album section of OnePlus Photo application. The last major change in this version is now we can hide the nav bar and can still able to use circle to search feature. I think this is a major feature because in the previous OxygenOS builds, we always needed to keep the nav bar active to use circle to search. But now, even if you hide the nav bar by long pressing in the same location of the nav bar, we can activate the circle to search. Vibration haptic feedback of circle to search is now more refined in this build. Most of you always ask two important questions. The first one is, how is the performance of this version? The device is running very smooth on this version. OnePlus did great job for optimizations of this OS. But it's important to check if this performance will sustain for long-term uses or not. Second one is, how is battery life? To answer these both questions, in upcoming 2 to 3 days after intensive testing of this device in a real life, I will release the separate second part of this video about performance, battery life and gaming in comparison with old OxygenOS 16 version. We will also discuss if I encounter any other issues in this update, so stay tuned. Now we will check out which issues I am facing in this build. OnePlus recently added AR Speak in Smart Sidebar via AR Service Engine update. But it's not responding in any of applications, showing an error as AI Speak is not supported on this page. This error is present in all OnePlus devices running with this version. Next is, I did the small test for gaming performance of this version, which is lagging in the previous build. I am surprised because 120 FPS is not working while playing BGMI in this version. It's fluctuating between 30 to 90 FPS and 120 FPS is not working at all. We will test and discuss this issue in our upcoming second part of this video. This is all about for today, guys. Stay tuned for our another video review on performance, battery life and the gaming of this version, which I will release soon. If you like our work, then please do like, hype and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to OnePlus, OxygenOS and Android mods. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.